Hey, what's up you guys? It's me, Sanne, and I'm back with another beauty video. Of course. Today I just wanted to have like a chill little video. I didn't want to do anything specific, like review something or something like that. I still have a few new makeup products that I haven't tried yet that I wanted to try out this week anyway. So I just wanted to sit down, do my makeup, have a little chat with it, you know, casual. That's what I wanted to do, just like a little get ready with me makeup look and just chat about a few things. I also asked people to send in some questions on Instagram, which they did. So I do have quite a bunch of questions. Some things like about me, makeup, my personal life, anything. I'm just gonna go through these questions and do my makeup and chat about a few little things, and we can just sit here just like we're actual best friends and just have a little chit chat together, you know. That's what I want, because I'm bored. That the giant forehead has emerged. My hair is out of the way. I can get started, so I'm just gonna do my makeup, and then I have my phone over here where I have your guys' questions, and I think I'm just gonna hop into the first question because I got quite a few questions. Some of them more beauty related and some of them more about my personal life, and there were actually a few questions which kind of had like the same topic, so I thought I'd just answer those in a row so it actually is one story, you know. So the first question that I got is about uni, and the question is, what are you studying in university? Let me just explain this carefully because it's a bit confusing right now. Okay, and 3 years ago I started studying on my bachelor's degree in biology. So the study is called biology and medical biology. I studied it at the Radboud University in the Netherlands. It's quite a big, like, it's quite a big study, very open, lots of different concepts. And then in the end you can like choose between more of like medical biology concepts and green biology concepts. So I started my bachelor in 2017. I did my minors in medical biology. So I did study towards medical biology. I don't have my bachelor's degree yet. Like last school year, last academic year would have been my final year on my bachelor's, and then during the summer I would have got my degree. But because of Corona, it was quite impossible for me to find a decent internship, so I decided like I'm not gonna do an internship right now. I'm just gonna have a quarter for myself, work on myself, make sure I'm not burned out, you know, and then do my internship during the next year and then move on to my master's. But then because of Corona, they gave us the opportunity to already start on your master's if you didn't completely finish your bachelor's yet. So I took that opportunity because it just fit into my schedule a bit better. Last quarter I already did my compulsory courses of my master's in medical biology. In short, what I'm studying is I'm still working on my bachelor's in biology, and I have just started my master's degree in medical biology. That's it. That's kind of the short version. So that's what I'm studying, and that kind of ties into the next question, which was, what kind of internship are you doing? So I just started my internship last week, actually. I'm like doing half internship and half study. I found an internship spot at our hospital that is linked to our university, so it's the Radboud UMC. I'm doing an internship at the human genetics department, which is really fun. I really like genetics. It's really interesting. They did offer me a data analysis internship, so that's what I'm doing right now. There have been people who have shown very severe and deadly side effects to certain commonly used medication for like cancer medication and such, and I need to find out, or I'm trying to find out, if those people have some sort of small mutation or polymorphism that caused them to react differently to the medication than other people do. I'm very excited about it. The only thing is that I have to do my internship from home. I do my internship on Mondays, Tuesdays and Wednesdays, and I'll just sit there in my room, just typing away on my little laptop, doing my research, and that's it. Yeah, that is my internship currently. I'm just, okay, I wanted to talk to you about this foundation for a bit. This is the foundation that I used in last video as well. The Essence Pretty Natural foundation. I was just very confused because it left just weird patches when I started applying concealer on top. The thing is, this foundation just dries down very quickly. So the thing I did right now is I first applied concealer and then I applied foundation on top. So that's working out quite well. Yeah, as far as I can see, I don't really have any weird patches or anything. I'm just gonna quickly move on because I've only done two products and I've only done two questions. I can talk for hours, literally hours. So we need to watch out with that. Okay, and the next question that I got was also kind of like related to uni, because the question is, how do you combine everything? How do you combine uni and YouTube, etc.? Answer to the question is, I don't. I'm really not good at it. The thing is, I took a quarter off to look to like work on myself and do stuff for myself and such. And I actually used that quarter to work a lot more on my blog and my YouTube and really expand that. So I kind of like worked on that as if it was almost a full-time job. So I spent a lot of time on that. But when I started uni again after the summer vacation, like I started like, I had to start strong. It took a lot of my time, which of course it's a full-time study. It's not that weird. But the thing is that I really wanted to keep working on my blog at the same level I was working on it before, but of course that's not feasible. I can't put a full like 46 hour work week working on my blog and also a full 46 hour work week working on school. You know, that's just not possible. And in the meantime, I had to look for an internship and do all those kinds of things. So right now, I'm not combining it at all. It's not going well. It used to always go well for me because I didn't make myself like a very tight schedule for my blog, but now I have a much fuller schedule for my blog in mind, and of course that isn't well combined with a full-time study. Okay, I think we like got over all the uni questions and such. You know, I have a fun little, like a few little favorites questions in my inbox. Question: what's your favorite snack? I don't know. I legit don't know. I love food way too much. I like so many types of food, so many types of snacks. I'm just gonna list a few snacks that I really like. Doritos Tortilla chips, but then like the spicy, like the chili flavored ones. Those are really good. I really love those. Currently, I like to eat a lot of dates with peanut butter. I love gummy bears. What do I like to snack on? Chocolate. I do love chocolate. No, I don't know. I don't have a favorite snack because I just love all kinds of different snacks. I really don't know. You can wake me up in the middle of the night for literally almost any snack, so. I'm not a really complicated person. I just like food. Blush, next thing. Ooh. Okay, next question. Who would be your dream person to collab with? That's a tough one. I might be, you know, a beauty YouTuber. I don't watch a lot of beauty YouTube videos currently. I like to watch Angelica Oles. She does fun stuff. She has like a drama channel. And she's just a fun person to like kind of hang out with when you're watching the video, you know? She has a second channel where she does like makeup videos and such. And I don't know. I feel like it would be fun to hang out with her and do a collab with her. Y'all really sent some fun questions. If you were only allowed to use two makeup products for an entire year, what products would they be? Okay, the thing is, like, on the usual, if I wear makeup, I just wear concealer and mascara. So if I want to use that for a year, then at least I'll look decent in every single picture, you know? But I die because I can't have my eyeshadow and be creative and do fun things. So I'm inclined to pick like one big eyeshadow palette as well. Either concealer and a big eyeshadow palette with loads of color, or concealer and mascara. That's a tough one though. While I do my eyebrows, I'm just gonna do another question. What's your favorite color? That's an easy one. It's yellow. Yellow is my absolute favorite color. It's so bright, so happy. It looks so adorable with anything. Yeah, my favorite color is yellow, but I do really like pink and burgundy and like mint. Mint is great. I like lots of colors. I just like color in my life in general. Next question, which was always so in there, is what is your favorite music? Like, my favorite genre of music that I like to listen to is rock, and like indie rock, hard rock, like anything like that. I do enjoy almost every single style of music. I really don't mind, but in my free time, I just, when I have to pick my own music to listen to, I always pick some rock bands. Like, my favorite bands are Alter Bridge and Royal Blood. I really like 21 Pilots, which isn't really rock, but still, I really like them. And Panic at the Disco, Fall Out Boy, so, you know, then Emo Trinity, Highly Suspect, Shinedown. I like loads of things. But yeah, like, my favorite music is rock. And I also had a question, what's your favorite song? I don't really do favorite songs. I do have a song that I have literally loved for the past few years, and that's Blackbird by Alter Bridge. And I feel like I will forever love that song. I will never grow tired of it. So that's kind of my lifelong favorite song, I think. There's loads of songs that I really, really like. But yeah, like, favorite song, the song I like to listen to right now is, I think, Impossible by Nothing But Thieves, the orchestra edition. And my all-time favorite song would be Blackbird by Alter Bridge. I think it might change just any second, you know? But yeah, I really like those songs. I'm just trying to move through this a bit quick, but I feel like my base makeup is done and I can start on my eyes. So I'm thinking of doing like a bit of a glam look with a neon purple graphic liner and then applying the purple shimmer like on my eye. So what I'm gonna do first is apply a tiny bit of concealer on my eyelids because I did not bring an eyeshadow primer. Okay, so I'm just gonna go in with a fluffy blending brush and this lovely pinky shade, and we'll just see what happens. This is such a nice pink shade. It's so cute. While I'm busy with this, I thought I'd answer one of the more juicy questions, which is, are there any makeup brands you don't support? There's like loads of brands I don't support. In general, it's because I like to shop cruelty-free. And with that, I mean completely cruelty-free. So I don't want any of those shady brands who say they're cruelty-free, but still go out and sell their products in China, where it's mandatory of the products to be tested on animals anyway. That's shady. I don't like that. Besides that, I try to not support any fast fashion brands, since they're really not well for the environment. And they don't pay their workers well enough, so I try to shop secondhand to avoid that. I must say I'm not that big into like the drama community, so I often don't know about brands that did something shady behind our backs or whatever. Except, you know, Jeremiah Starfish. But I do have a few brands which I'm very comfortable in using, so that's nice. I think I'm gonna cut my crease a bit and then apply that purple shimmer on top of it. And then the next question is, what is your favorite meal? Which is probably gonna result in a similar answer to what's your favorite snack, because I just freaking love food. If you ask me about my favorite cuisines, you know, that's a bit easier for me to answer, since I freaking love Indonesian. I also love Japanese. And Italian is just my thing. I just freaking love pasta. Anything pasta, just give it to me. Oh, I live for pasta. Okay, I did like half good creases. Lovely. You know. So now it's gonna be the exciting part, because now I can actually try out the pigments that I bought. So I think how I'm gonna do this is I'm gonna grab a flat brush and I'm gonna spray that in setting spray, and then I'm gonna dip it into that glitter. I've never used pigments before, so this is also just very scary. I have no idea how this is gonna turn out. Do we want to have another question in the meantime? What's your favorite thing to do? Well, okay, the thing is, one of my favorite things to do is makeup, of course, obviously, otherwise I wouldn't be doing this. I don't know, I like to do loads of things. Like, I also just like to read or watch Netflix. So I don't know, there's not really my favorite thing to do, but one of my favorite things to do is definitely my makeup. Oh no, oh! Now I have a glitter mustache. Yeah, that's great. Okay, so I feel like it looks pretty patchy and I'm completely covered in glitters, but I kind of have this glitter thing on my eye right now. Like, it is a really pretty purple, but why did I choose the purple? It looks so weird. Okay, so I'm literally covered in big... Okay, we're just gonna try to see where, like, how this will go when I make an eyeliner. Okay, let me just in the meantime try to answer the next question, which is, if you could live anywhere in the world, where would you want to live? There's loads of places which I'm very sure about that I want to visit and maybe live at someday, but for some reason I would love to live in Australia. Don't know why, because I hate literally everything that crawls and moves in a way that's not natural. So, like, Australia shouldn't be the place for me, but for some reason I would love to live in Australia. At least remind me next time I'm using these pigments. I need to do my base after my eye makeup. Oh my god. I'm literally covered in purple and glitter. It's everywhere. This eyeliner shape, atrocious. When you look like this from a bit of a distance, it's kind of cute. And while we do our highlighter, I'm going on to the next question, which is, how has your style changed over time? Like, makeup, clothing, or mindset, or whatever. I think, like, the most drastic change that all of my styles have done is when I was, like, a teenager, I wanted to be, like, edgy. I'd like to wear only black. The last couple of years, I changed from, like, this all black sort of aesthetic to color, loads of color. Like, not just in my outfits, but also in my makeup. I used to do only, like, eyeliner, just normal black eyeliner, or just some neutral looks, and now I'm doing stuff like this, you know. Like, I just wear color on the daily because it just makes me, like, it just makes life a lot more fun to have color. I also still like black stuff. Like, I'm wearing all black today and I still like to look edgy sometimes, but I also have, like, very cute, very colorful vintage things. I can express my fun personality a lot more, and I enjoy that. That's one lash down. Next one, and then we'll also move on to the next question, because there's a few more questions. One of which is, what do you do to stay in a positive mindset? Which is somewhat a difficult question for me. But things that I've been doing recently, which I do enjoy and do help a bit, is I just write down, like, every single time I think of something, I write down what I'm grateful for. I don't know. I don't know. It's a pretty tough question for me, because I don't always get out of my negative mindset, you know? I just have a few more things to do, just a few tiny things, and one more question. If you had to change one thing about your makeup style, what would it be? I think my makeup style currently is very, like, colorful glam. That's kind of it. I think if I have to change anything from my style, I think, like, I don't necessarily change, but I want to, like, try out more editorial stuff and do more editorial stuff and maybe go into that style a bit more. So I think that's what I would change. So yeah, those are actually all the questions I had chosen. So I'm just going to quickly do some lip gloss and whatever, and then also the makeup look is done, and then we can, you know, say our goodbyes. This is the final look. I answered all the questions you guys had for me. If you have any more questions, you can leave them below or just send me a DM or anything on Instagram. And if you follow me on Instagram, you can participate in any of my next videos if I do another one like this. I want to thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please give it a thumbs up. Subscribe to my channel if you want to see more from me. If you want to see even more from me, all my blogs and socials are linked down below, so you can check me out there as well. And that's it for today. I want to thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time. Toodles!